Yo, this is Slammer again, back in the Welsh Champs 2009. Here with Tough Tim Twist. What up, Tim?
What's up?
You good?
Yeah, not too bad.
Listen, I've got a couple of questions I want to ask you. First question, when you won the UK Champs, how did it feel being in so much pain?
At the time, I didn't feel the pain, you know what I mean? It was like, that's why I carried on. That's why I wanted to keep dancing. It was totally, my mind was blank to the pain. I just knew I had to do what I had to do, you know what I mean?
Mm. It's afterwards that the pain kicks in.
Yeah, I mean, for about 6 months after that, I couldn't, you know, barely walk, you know what I mean?
Tim, being in a Rocksteady crew, the legendary Rocksteady crew, how does that make you feel?
Pure pride, without a doubt, you know what I mean? Because, I mean, the roots of the culture and the dance started with the likes of Rocksteady. They were one of the pioneer crews that blew it up worldwide. So it was always like a dream. And it was like a dream, you know, imagining back in the 80s when I first started doing this, imagining being in the crew like Rocksteady was just a dream, it was just a pipe dream. Yeah. There was no way it was ever going to happen, you know what I mean? And by the time it came around, it was like unbelievable. And it was like a natural transition for me to be doing that, because I was like kind of like living what I believed Rocksteady stood for originally anyway. So me taking on the role of being a Rocksteady member when I did, it was natural. It was easy. I didn't have to think about it. I didn't have to like figure out what I had to do to be a Rocksteady member, because I was already...
What you wanted to do.
Yeah, I was already doing that anyway, you know what I mean? As far as like hip-hop goes, to me, they were like the epitome of what hip-hop was, you know what I mean? Or what a b-boy was back in the 80s. So I just rolled with it and carried and continued with that, you know what I mean? Until this day, basically, that's my ethos. I believe in what traditionally Rocksteady believed in.
Yeah.
Regardless of all the other stuff that goes on, you know what I mean? That people know or don't know about. Being in Rocksteady to me is just pure pride, definitely.
Cool. So outside of b-boying then, who inspired you? Or who inspires you?
Outside of b-boying.
Yeah.
Over the years, it changes continuously, you know what I mean? B-boying, you know, to live life, b-boying has made me who I am. It's given me the attributes that make you a person in life, you know, give it dedication, hardworking, trustworthy, you know, how to be on time, how to deal with people correctly, how to be honest, how to be truthful. They're important things, I believe, to be as a human being. So hip-hop has taught me all that. Outside of hip-hop, before being a b-boy, I was also into Northern Soul before hip-hop, b-boying. Mm-hmm. I was a dancer as well. So I was already dancing to like stuff like James Brown before I realised I knew who he was. So that people, and music has always inspired me, you know what I mean? But, and I've always been an artist as well. So art inspires me. Music has inspired me, but there's many different things. The Beatles, James Brown, all the Northern Soul, all the Motown stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That inspires me. People like, you know, Earth, Wind and Fire, stuff like that, definitely inspires me. But travel inspires me a lot. Traveling, seeing things, you know, seeing other locations, other places inspires me.
What's your most memorable bit of history in the UK b-boy scene?
I mean, UK Fresh. I went to UK Fresh, but I mean, again, there's so many different things, man. I mean, growing up on the scene back in the 80s, seeing Street Machine for the first time, the crew from Manchester, they were a massive inspiration. After Rocksteady, when Rocksteady were my first inspiration, after seeing Street Machine, they were like the next thing to take me to another level, you know what I mean? They really inspired me. I kind of like lived up to them, you know what I mean? I looked up to them and lived up to their reputation by trying to like, from seeing how they acted and the way they danced and the way they battled, I wanted to be like them, you know what I mean? Mm. So that was like a big memory of mine. I always go back into when I'm looking for inspiration, you know what I mean? UK Fresh definitely was a turning point, or was a big event that went on over there, you know what I mean? It was a massive event. Second to none, meeting them was memorable, you know what I mean? It was important as well to me, because it was at a time when there was very few of us dancing in the country. And they opened up my eyes and my crew's arisings to the European scene.
Mm-hmm.
They were important to me, definitely. And seeing the new generation, seeing this now, where we are today, present day UK hip hop, seeing that get to a level where it's living alongside the rest of the world as far as hip hop goes. It's took a long time to get to this place, you know what I mean? For many years we were like, I mean, originally we were the second place behind New York. It was New York hip hop and the UK.
Yeah.
You go around Europe in the early 80s and that's them where it was second, where did they look to? It was New York and then London basically,
yeah,
you know
yeah.
what I mean? So that was very important to me. I moved down to London when hip hop started to die around the country. London held on to it a bit more because of its nature. That city has got its own, it's very similar to New York, so it's got its own networking system, you know what I mean? So going to London was a big inspiration to me and very important to me as far as like my progress in hip hop, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And that was back in 85, 86, I was living down there. And I went specifically for hip hop, you know what I mean? So to advance my hip hop life, basically, you know what I mean? I met a lot of people down there that just pushed me forward. But
cool.
It was weird as well, at the same time, all these people I met along the way dropped off. And I looked to them, they were always telling me, go away, learn something, come back when you've learned something and you can prove to me that you're worthy of talking to. I went away, I did that, come back, and they're gone.
Yeah.
That was the story with most people, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
And I continued because I believed in what they were telling me and they didn't believe it in that themselves, you know what I mean? I've got to remember though, at the same time, we were all very young. When we all started this back in the 80s, we were very young.
Mm.
So by the time we all, it had peaked and gone back down and most people retired, we were too young to understand what we were doing, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
luckily,
yeah.
Most people, if you're living in a big city, you represent your city. I was living in a small town. So to me, I was representing hip hop, which is New York.
Yeah.
So I was never just about my area or my town or my city. So to me, hip hop was
a bigger thing
to me. So maybe, I mean, my passion for that drove me and carried me on through the hard times. I didn't rely too much on who was still doing it around me because I had a bigger picture in my head. Hip hop, almost to a certain extent, was existing in my mind, regardless of whether it was around me. And you know, I get lost in my drawings or my paintings or my videos or my books or whatever, you know what I mean? So it never went away, even when it was away, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So,
cool, cool.
Yeah, they were important times to me.
Very good. Tim, pleasure.
Cool.
Welsh Champs 2009.
See you later. Rocksteady Crew worldwide. Peace.
Peace.